Hello, in this video, we will learn about nuclear receptors. We will see some basics about them and the signaling by glucocorticoids. Let's get started. First of all, these receptors are located inside the cell in contrast to other type of receptors which are located on the cell membrane. Their ligands are lipid soluble, so they can cross the membrane and bind the receptors located inside the cell. These receptors are transcription factors. This means they regulate gene expression and protein synthesis. There are two main subfamilies of these receptors. One family contains receptors for steroid hormones, for example, glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, androgens, estrogens, etc. The other family consists of receptors for vitamin D, thyroid hormones, and retinoic acid. Apart from these, other nuclear receptors recognize a wide range of xenobiotics and metabolites. Now let's talk about their exact locations. Different type of receptors are found at different sites under their inactive state. Glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid receptors are located in the cytoplasm under resting condition. Estrogen and progesterone receptors are found in the nucleus. And receptors for thyroid hormone and retinoic acid are attached to DNA even under resting conditions. Now let's see the structure of the nuclear receptors. They have three main domains: a ligand-binding domain where the ligand binds, a DNA-binding domain that binds with the DNA, and a transactivation domain that brings about changes in the DNA conformation to initiate transcription. So this was the basic about nuclear receptor. Now let's see the signaling pathway for glucocorticoid receptors. As we have already seen, they are found in the cytoplasm. Now these receptors are inherently capable of binding with the respective genes. But under the resting state, their activity is prevented by a chaperone protein like heat shock protein 90. The binding of a ligand with the ligand binding domain causes a release of SHP19. Now two of such receptors dimerize and get activated. The pair then enters the nucleus. It also binds with a coregulator. The coregulator can be a co-activator or a co-repressor. Finally, the complex attaches to the specific region in the gene. In case of glucocorticoids, it's a glucocorticoid responsive element. This binding facilitates or suppresses gene expression. If it's facilitation, mRNA is produced that goes to the cytoplasm and transcribed to respective proteins. The proteins then bring about changes in cellular activity. Now, the synthesis of proteins takes time. So, the effect of nuclear receptors develops slowly and takes longer than other signaling pathways. However, once the effect has developed, it also lasts longer. That is because even when the stimulus is removed, the newly synthesized proteins will stay there for a while and work till they are degraded. So that was an example of signaling by nuclear receptor. Now let's have a quick summary. Nuclear receptors are located inside the cell. They bind with a lipophilic ligand molecule. They are transcription factors. They have a ligand binding domain, DNA binding domain, and transactivation domain. Under resting state, glucocorticoid receptors are located in the cytoplasm and are bound to chaperone protein HSP90. It prevents its activity. Binding of glucocorticoid causes release of chaperone protein, dimerization, entry into the nucleus, binding with coregulator, binding with DNA, and modulation of transcriptional activity. Because of involvement of protein synthesis, their effects are slow to appear and slow to disappear. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Non-Stop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.